Our next presentation is on life cycle cost analysis of ultra high performance concrete UHPC in retrofitting techniques for ABC project. Dr. Carlos Chang is going to present this project. Dr. Chang.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you for the opportunity to share the work progress in this project. This is an effort in order to quantify and see what are the benefits of using UHPC in retrofitting techniques for ABC projects. It's kind of right now the idea that ultra high performance concrete might be too expensive, but that could be the cost initial. And in reality, in the long term, will save a lot of money. However, that's kind of an assumption, that's kind of a perception. But how can we really compare the alternatives with numbers and see what are the options and the strategies? So that's what motivates us to work in this this project. And I want to also acknowledge the collaboration of my graduate student, Abid Hussain, who is working and making progress on this project. Just a quick brief reminder of what are the objectives. As I said, there are a lot of potential benefits, and we want to quantify it in monetary terms, see what are the factors that are being affected, how can be used for maintenance, trying to be more proactive than reactive. We also know, understand that the use of these new materials or timely maintenance can increase the life expectancy. And that's one of the other things that we've been looking for, how we can predict like life expectancy, what models we can use. And we are in that process that I will explain in the next slides. And kind of the what we're going after, like once we have this project complete, that the products that we'll be developing will be able to support management decisions, either network and project level. I also going to share some of the challenges we're facing at this moment. Also to mention that this is part, of course, of a larger goal, larger objectives of the ABC UTC Center. You have already listened in some of the other projects. There are many, many. This fits very well with all the other ones. We are working together to make a big effort to have the ABC systems, timely maintenance bridges, increase life expectancy, mitigate the climate change. So it's in that umbrella that we're looking for. And in reality, looking always for improve the performance over time and saving money in the long term. The work plan and kind of where we are, and I will just give you some highlights of how we were evolving in this project, just to be better informed. We are currently in task four, and task four is really the core of the process, life cycle cost analysis. I have to mention that life cycle cost analysis, majority of you will say, okay, this is not really new. But the new thing is how can we use the models from UHPC? What models can we use? What tools? What will be the cost? Is the application and the special features that we have for these particular retrofitting techniques that make it the challenge? So for that, we started looking at first in task one that we completed already, and it's kind of the foundation for the other ones, in the review of the state of practice. What are the current practice? What techniques are being used? And in that way, we can do a comparison. That was task four. So doing a comparison side by side for the same kind of problem that we might found from an evaluation of a bridge, we could comparing a traditional, what we call traditional technique with a new one with this material, the UHPC, and see what's going on. Now, in task three, as I said, part of the big challenge is the cost effectiveness models, in particular for UHPC, because there is not a lot of historical data, and I will mention how we are dealing with that. So we are now in task four. We envision also to have a case study with numerical example in order to illustrate the whole process. And then we'll prepare a final report and also develop some educational material. That's the project itself. Let me walk you through just highlighting a few aspects that we have found as long as we were moving forward in this project. So the first of all, that is kind of obvious, but still has been confirmed, it's possible to use UHPC in retrofitting techniques. It can be used for repairing. There is a lot of documentation on that in different areas, especially on the technical aspect. There are applications that can be used. So the literature review kind of confirmed what we kind of knew before. And there are some analytical approaches, but not all of them can be applied to the UHPC in particular, or there are some limitations in the data, depending on what model you want to use. So we found some models, we found some tools, but they are not ready to use. They have strengths and weaknesses that we look at. We are trying to build on what exists as much as possible, but we know there are limitations. So we prepare, and that will be documenting, it's already documenting in the quarterly report, but we'll document us in the final. These are preliminary. We prepare different kind of tables, summary tables, like the bridge components. So mainly the way we see it, the retrofitting techniques, you can have a conventional technology or innovative technology and go by element. So really there are different elements, and this is just a partial example where we can compare side by side for the element that we're looking at, what could be the convention technology and what would be the innovative technology. So we look at that one, we did some categories classification. We also look at materials because in the practice, we know that for certain problem that has to be solved, there might be different options. One might be conventional, or there might be other materials that might be competing with UHPC. So the idea is that we can compare, the DOT or the agency should have that capability of comparing different techniques, but at the same time, kind of different materials. And we were documenting factors that might be affecting the life cycle cost or the analysis itself, like how the method can be applied, the properties of the material itself, how can be used. So we look at different properties, and this is kind of what we were doing the documentation. In task two, we move to start kind of analyzing closer a comparison. We compare techniques, we start coming with some diagrams, and we kind of grouping into major categories, repair, so kind of minor damage compared to replacement techniques. You have the elements, and then depending on the element, we came up with some criteria in order to categorize where will fit the activity that needs to be done. So just in general terms, to have a really general overview, we have factors for comparison, and we consider that in particular for ABC, the construction method is one factor, the time we're saving, the deterioration factors, of course, that the properties will make it last longer. So we were looking at the different factors from different perspective, depending on the technique to compare materials, and depending also on the element. So we look at element level, but we also have a view on the overall bridge as a whole that we'll discuss when we're doing the models. Now, we're developing some flowcharts. We try to create guidelines that will help with comparison. It's not really the major core of this project, but everything will start with the selection of what's the technique. And this is just kind of a general guideline of the factors. We know we need data, so we have to start or rely on a bridge inventory. The data could be expanded. We made some suggestions to expand the data. There are condition ratings already exist in several data. Repair history will be good to have. Corrosion data, that seems to be a big factor. And of course, life cycle cost data. That's part of one component that we found is not really well documented, even for the current techniques. If you look at the diagram on the right-hand side, we have the step one is just evaluate the bridge damage. We know there are AASHTO procedures for that, kind of determine the cost. You need to know what's the cost, then see what's the substrate concrete. We are referring to specific standards in the documents to do that. And then, well, we identify what's the retrofitting techniques to repair the damage. Once we know what are the alternatives, technically speaking, we kind of have in those big categories repair or replacement. So it's the replacement, we go to one route. If it's a repair, we go to the other one. And we establish criteria for repair. We're going to propose the repair materials for that one, and that will be documented and helping with different charts for guidance. Evaluate the performance with certain models, and that will be part of the integrated life cycle cost analysis, because we need those models to see which one is more cost effective. So that's kind of the framework for the comparison. And to go more specifically on the life expectancy models, we know that there are deterministic, probabilistic. I think we need some sort of a combination, or at least two stage, or give two options possible. If there is need to develop models by itself, because there are some of them that are not specifically for a HPC, and with the proper data, depending on the complexity, we can use regression, binary logistic. We are also documenting that, and giving the possibility of using those techniques in case there is enough data for do that. So we don't want to eliminate any kind of the options in the spectrum of analysis, even if it's there or not data. That's what we have. Now, one interesting model that we found that in general terms that can be applied and is in many, many software is this one, the corrosion iteration model. There are some variations in the equation itself or in the factors, but in general terms, that's a, I would say, popular model, kind of to see what's the life expectancy and when might start corrosion, and it's kind of initiation phase, propagation phase. It's very well documented. And in fact, there is a tool that we found, Life365, that has the iteration model, but we think there are some situations that make it not feasible to use directly. We can use it maybe partially to get some data that we can use for life cycle cost analysis, but will require a little bit more of information. Now, going to the core, which is the cycle cost analysis, as I said, it's not really new. I just mentioned about defining the bridge retrofitting techniques, which were providing just general guidelines. But these are really the stages. Determine the analysis period, could be 50 years, could be 40 years. We are making recommendations. Then select the iteration model. We are making recommendations of that. We saw that the existing ones needs some additional analysis and study and development. Define the life cycle activities, maintenance, review the results, and then we'll calculate the net present value here after the refining activities to estimate the cost, calculate net present value equivalent, review the life cycles, and finally make a recommendation on what's the technique that we have. So in that process, we are reviewing the previous analysis going by elements, looking for the alternatives. For each alternative, it's very broad, and we are trying to focus on the ones that probably have more data for illustrating the whole process. But at this point, from the development, we are not excluding any element or any alternatives. So you can see here the two groups, repairs or rehabilitation for each element as an example, kind of the UHPC and the conventional, which is the idea to compare one-to-one with the cost, one-to-one technicals, assuming both of them are technically feasible for that repair. Life cycle cost analysis include the length of analysis. The longer, you can get more, but if you go too long, you may face uncertainty factors that you cannot quantify as well as you would like. Typically cost, ANC cost, user cost, we plan to have two separate sections so that the DOTs can compare, or the ANC salvage value, probably most likely needed, because the life expectancy on conventional will be shorter than the UHPC. Then we have discount rate, inflation rate, and of course the performance models that we talk. ASC costs, this is traditional, what we call material, labor, the cost of the maintenance, material costs, labor costs, machinery costs, and then salvage value. So that's a kind of the traditional approach in the way of the structure. But as I said, kind of the challenge is looking what's the cost in for future and finding those costs in databases. Salvage value, we found that many times it's just a percentage of what's the base remaining life. There are many studies that has been already mentioned on non-proprietary UHPC mixes, but costs, as far as we know, not very well documented. We are trying to reach the community to see if we can find more data. I'm not going a lot of detail on these ones, but I just want to say that users' costs, there are different approaches already based on travel delay cost, the time for traveling or the time that will take the repair, the vehicle cost operating in that sense. There are references on that. The same with crash costs, if it's kind of closer for repair, less time, this might be a decrease, and also the environmental. So those are additional criteria that could be included in the life cycle costs. And again, the difficult part is the quantification. There are some approaches. Now, in the last part, kind of what we get is the net present value and the equivalent unit for annual costs. We are kind of towards recommending the equivalent unit annual for costs because of the length of the period and the different service life of the conventional with the UHPC. Kind of wrapping up, we are looking at data. I think there is really good information of the projects that has been done in one of the ABC UTC database. This is kind of from the overall, the network, and even sometimes we can find plans, specifications. As I said, we are searching on this, trying to get examples. And again, the challenges is get costs for what's going to be especially maintenance in the future, or what activities or the timing. That's the major challenge. That's kind of the aim. I just have some questions, but these are kind of summary in reality. Then we can have there's 1 or 2 minutes open. So these are my last slides. So the factors influencing the selection is the concrete material itself, the novelty and the properties. The time factor is another one, the duration, life expectancy. Those will be affecting the selection, technical and cost perspective. And then the models, the majority use condition rating, or we're using also corrosion. There is a software but that can do that. There are other ones, but they are not complete. We may have to do some Excel platform to complement. And that's what I was saying about modeling. That's one of the challenges, and we are working on this, kind of looking the existing ones and see other parameters that we can use, because history data is one issue, and also predicting to the future. Kind of we are planning is use what I call a hybrid deterioration model. So it's all sort of combination of MBA writings of how they rate the condition of the bridge, and also with the chloride content prediction. It seems to be an approach that might be feasible and could be applied and develop a sort of a hybrid model. And the major challenge in life cycle cost analysis is not the method, not really the equations, but in addition to the modeling, is the cost, that historical cost or future, we couldn't find more. There are examples or costs that we can reach. I will appreciate that. Let me know, and we can contact you and try to use those for our illustration. So that's where we are right now. And I try just to give you an overview of where we are, what we have done, and then what challenges we have. So I think I have 1 minute. I'm not so sure. I'm looking at 2 of my watches.
Yeah, we have a couple of minutes, Dr. Chang. Thank you very much for the presentation. There's a lot of material, I'm sure, to fit in this time frame is not easy. But one question there is about, I think you hinted, but this question is there about the modeling, deterioration modeling. So UHPC, are you going to develop a new model that applies to UHPC or use something, because it looks like from everything that it's completely different as of durability or so from a normal concrete or so.
That's an excellent question. That's what I call it, the hybrid. We are planning to use, at least for comparison, one of the existing models for the conventional. And we're planning to develop or fit, since we know the formulas, one model, and we are working on an Excel file for the UHPC. I think I have one slide after that even show that we know, for example, we have the chloride profile. We have some UHPC chloride profiles that might be used as a basic to develop the model and have some formulas. So we are exploring that situation. We know the existing ones are not sufficient and we will need a model. And how robust will be the model? That's kind of the question, because the data is kind of will kind of answer how precise, how accurate can be the model. But yes, we plan to provide a model for UHPC based on previous studies and kind of comparing with the conventional and see how they look with the current softwares and the spreadsheet that we'll be working on, because we know the equations, but the parameters will change depending on UHPC.
Thank you very much, Dr. Chang. So we are at the end of the time. I'm sure any question not answered can be directed to Dr. Chang. The information is right on the slide, or you can find it in our website.
Just to close, Armin, I want to thank you for this effort. I know there are many other ones, but since we are struggling with data or costs, if somebody has some data, we're willing to try, check it out, and see what if we can use that data for our methodology.
Yes, we will really appreciate if somebody has it. Thank you again. Yes,
thank you very much.